Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what benefit does it get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me and you to prevent and stop ourselves from eating and drinking from dawn till sunset? From dawn till sunset, what benefit does it come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There's no benefit. There's no benefit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The benefit is to me and you. The benefit is to me and you. Now this fasting of Ramadan, in the narration of Bukhari, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give all the deeds and actions of His servant. He would give it to His angels and say that, "Oh my angels, give this reward to this reward and this reward to this reward." But Allah says that in the month of Ramadan, if solely with the intention of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a person fasts, Allah says that I myself will give the reward. I myself will give the reward. Just imagine, in worldly matters, just imagine if you passed your exam in school or college, or you got a PhD in university, and you got in such a great level, and your marks were so great that the Prime Minister of the country had to come and reward you. How would you feel? And you was on the media, on big TV. My gosh, you'll be over the moon. Just imagine, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be rewarding you in front of the entire whole ummah. And Allah will reward you in personal, not through the angel. Allah will reward you in personal. May Allah grant us, ameen. May Allah grant us and overlook our shortcomings, our mistakes and sins that we are committing in Ramadan. And Allah forgive us our past, present and future. May Allah accept our Ramadan. Make this a najat for us. So Allah will reward this month of Ramadan. What benefit does it give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There's no benefit. The benefit is for ourselves. In Ramadan itself, you would not imagine. There's so many worldly benefits. There's so many worldly benefits. And ukhrawi benefit is unimaginable. The benefit that you will get in the latter world after death is unimaginable. Only 30 days. Allah says, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Allah says, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Allah says, only a very short period of time, a couple of days. Only a very short period of time. Just for a couple of days, you are fasting. أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. For a very short period of time. So just imagine, in Akhirat, the amount of sawab and reward and ajr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give me and you. Three things we have to remember in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was more in the month of Ramadan. One, his ibadah and worship used to become more and greater and severe, because you have to remember that Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala has said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he used to stand in salah, his feet used to get swollen. Now if this was happening out of Ramadan, subhanallah, how did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam worship Allah in Ramadan? There is no parallel. We cannot imagine. So the ibadah has to increase. If I didn't read Quran throughout the year, my reciting of Quran should become more. If I didn't give charity throughout the whole year, my charity should become more. If I didn't do dhikr throughout the whole year, my dhikr should become more. If I did not refrain and stop myself from haram, from sins, from many kind of sins, I should stop myself in the month of Ramadan. So his ibadah became more. And secondly, Rasulullah ﷺ, وَكَانَ أَجْوَدُ النَّاسِ. Rasulullah ﷺ was the most kindest amongst the human creation. Even the animals felt his kindness. Even the animals felt his kindness. But in the month of Ramadan, what does he say in the Bukhari, in the riwayat of Bukhari? كَرِيحِ الْمُرْسَلَى. That his kindness used to become so kind that the sweetness of the blazing wind in the early morning. So kind Rasulullah ﷺ used to become. The generosity of Rasulullah ﷺ used to become greater. Greater. So what? His ibadah used to become more. His charity used to become more. And thirdly, the dua of Rasulullah ﷺ. He comes in the narration that Allah Ta'ala orders the malaika, the angels, only in Ramadan, specifically, only in Ramadan, not out of Ramadan. Only in Ramadan Allah orders the angels, the malaika, that the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is fasting, and your duty is only you say Ameen. Only you say Ameen to the dua of the ummah. 5 Ramadan has gone, 25 maybe to go. 5 Ramadan has gone. How many times have we lift our hands and made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Obviously, our Imam has explained last week, what dua do we ask? We ask Allah for Jannah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka Jannah. Wa na'udhu bika minan Naar. If you don't know this, just say in your language, oh Allah, I ask you for Jannah and seek refuge from the fire of Jahannam. I ask you for Jannah and seek refuge from the fire of Jahannam. Everyone can say this. And reading Kalima and making Istighfar. Reading Kalima and making Istighfar. The easy source is, after every namaz, make dua. Before every salat, make dua. And the most important time, Salasatun la taruddu da'watahum. As-sa'im hatta yuftir. 3 categories of people, their dua will not be rejected, not be rejected. When the fasting person is sitting in front of the food, sitting on that plate, and he's looking at the clock, countdown, he's looking at the time, and he's eager to touch that samosa, he's eager and he's ready to touch that tamar. He's eager, ready to eat his food. And at that time, he lifts his hand and he makes dua. This is the most important time, at the time of iftar. At the time of iftar, we shouldn't be busy cooking. At least before 10-15 minutes, keep it in your hand. And 15 to 10 minutes, lift your hands, make dua. If you can't make dua, take a dua book. Like for example, Hisnul Muslim. In these dua books, there are most authentic duas from Quran and Sunnah. Take this dua book and start reading these duas one by one. Read these duas. Read these duas. Or read Durood Sharif. Read Durood Sharif. The durood that you read in Salah. The durood that you read in Salah. And just before iftar, when you stop your dua, just keep on saying, Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah wa na'udhu bika minan nar. Just 1 minute, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, or half a minute before you break your fast, Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah wa na'udhu bika minan nar. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah wa na'udhu bika minan nar. Allah will accept. So 3 things Rasulullah ﷺ used to do more in the month of Ramadan. What? He used to worship more. His charity used to become greater. He used to give more charity in the month of Ramadan. And his dua used to become more. Whenever he used to get chance, he used to make dua. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just imagine the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I make dua that Allah make us and the whole entire ummah in the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. in the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and especially the dua that he used to make in the month of Ramadan, especially the dua that he used to make, the dua in the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us and accept our deeds and accept our Ramadan, fasting in the month of Ramadan, and make this the means and salvation. This one little hadith I will quote. This one little hadith is a very famous hadith. إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ بَابٌ يُخَالُ لَهُ الرَّيَّانِ. In Jannah, there's many doors. There's many doors. But there will be one door. There's 8 doors. One door specifically for the fasting person. And this door, the name of this door will be Rayyan. Why will this door will be called Rayyan? This is the question. Why is this door called Rayyan? Because, do you know what is the most important thing and the most cherishing and wanting thing that a person wants when he's fasting? Do you know what? Water. Water. So Allah, in the place, He's gave a similar thing in Jannah. Allah, for the fasting person, Allah will give such water that you cannot imagine. The water will be immense. That once you drink this water, you will not imagine what kind of water you have. You've never forget the water of this world. Water doesn't have no taste. But the taste of the water of Jannah, subhanallah, we cannot imagine. So you can imagine what kind of water Allah has prepared for us in Jannah. What kind of water Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said that in Jannah there is a door, and this door will be called Rayyan, and this Rayyan will be given to the Sa'imun who has been fasting in the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you and me practice what has been said.